الله أكبر الله أكبر.
Muslims in Uganda joined the world to mark Eid al-Adha, which is celebrated throughout the Muslim world as a commemoration of Prophet Abraham's willingness to obey God by sacrificing his son. Eid al-Adha concludes the pilgrimage to the holy city of Mecca and kicks off the festival of the sacrifice that lasts for 4 days. It's the most important holiday in the Muslim calendar that is celebrated for 4 days, unlike Eid al-Fitr that is marked within just 1 day.
Sami'a Allahu liman hamidahu.
Kibuli Hill was painted white as Muslims from all walks of life flocked the mosque to celebrate the big day. Prayers were led by Sheikh Muhammad Shaban Galabuzi, who urged the faithful to fulfill the pillar of sacrifice and also try to share with the needy. After Eid al-Adha prayers at Kibuli, the titular head of Islam in Uganda, Sheikh Kasim Nachibinge Kakungulu, treated dignitaries to a luncheon at his home in Kibuli, from where he reminded the Muslims on the significance of the day.
We would like to ask Muslim brethren to live within the dictates of Islam, be able to make a sacrifice as ordained by the Almighty Allah. Share it with your neighbors, with family and friends, and even those who have less than what we have.
Nachibinge called on Ugandans to get frugal in their expenditure and spend their resources sparingly in order to endure the current tough economic situation that has seen prices of commodities skyrocket amid terrible inflation.
If you have any income stream, handle it with care, handle with caution, avoid extravagance, avoid spending it anyhow, because a shilling saved is a shilling, and the harsh times are still on because we don't know when the economic hardships will come to pass.
Nachibinge advises Ugandans to tighten their belts because factors responsible for the current inflation stem from abroad, but also asked government to show frugality in its expenses.
We like to ask the authorities, those in government, that please lead by example. Be frugal as well. Avoid overspending. Try to save whatever you can and channel those resources to the people who have less than what others have.
He also tasked security agencies to take strong response to the increased cases of highway robberies on major highways, where thugs mount unauthorized roadblocks to wreak havoc.
People clad in military fatigue who are setting up unauthorized checkpoints, robbing people of all their properties and belongings. We don't know the cause. We don't know if it is the economic situation or it's because of any other reasons. It's against that background that I wish to seek the indulgence of the Minister for Security and the Ministers for Internal Affairs, as well as the security chiefs, to look into this issue, find a way of solving it before it gets out of hand.
The Buganda Kingdom's Deputy Katikiro, Dr. Twaha Kawase, delivered the Kabaka's Eid al-Adha message at Kibuli.
On the economic hardships we are facing, we are grateful that Sabasajja Kabaka was able to point out that as you celebrate Eid, it is a day of sacrifice. We are going to be slaughtering animals. We need to remember that we have other people who are needy.
Dr. Muhammad Chigundu, the spokesperson of the Kibuli faction, urged the faithful to walk in the footsteps of the Prophet, who exhibited the highest degree of obedience to God.
The experience we learn from the action of Prophet Ibrahim is an action of obedience to Almighty God. This obedience is that he was instructed by Almighty God that he slaughters his only son, a son he had gotten at the age of 86. But with the instructions from Almighty God that he can slaughter him, he did obey his God.
This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.